I ask you to affirm your willingness to enter into this covenant of marriage and to share all the joys and sorrows of this new relationship. Ethan, will you have Nichole to be your wife in holy marriage? And will you love her faithfully as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I will with the help of God.
I will with the help of God.
Nichole, will you have Ethan to be your husband in holy marriage? And will you love him faithfully as long as you both shall live?
I will with the help of God.
I always knew this day would come, and as a father, you always want your daughter to be your little girl forever. I have to say, I've never seen you look more beautiful than you are today.
And I love her so, I wouldn't trade her for gold.
Ethan, when Nichole first brought you home, I thought to myself, self, how old is this kid? He looks like he's 14. Oh my God, Nichole's a cougar. Or she finally took Fran's advice to get him young and train him right. But all joking aside, I could not have picked a better man for my daughter. I'm comforted in knowing that you will love her, cherish her, provide for her and protect her. I am very proud to call you my son-in-law. Welcome to the family, Ethan.
I'm walking on moonbeams, and tear your curtains down. First sunlight is like gold.
I just want to give all of you here today a little backstory. Nichole and I were friends before we were sisters. Our parents bowled on leagues at the same bowling alley, and before they even thought about dating, Nichole and I were busy playing with Barbies and vandalizing the bathroom stalls. The first time Nichole and her dad came to my house, I remember getting mad at Nichole because she was bonding with my cat, Tiger. And if you know me, you know I take my cat's affection very seriously. For years and years, I listened to my boy crazy sister talk about her crushes, and I always tuned her out because it was the same story over and over again. At least until she met Ethan. His is the only story I remember. And yes, this is true. Nichole came home and she said she had gone to the bar with her friends, and all of a sudden she saw the cutest guy walk through the doors with the most amazing smile, and he was sort of country. She was like, who is that? I have to talk to him. And she did, and the rest was history. I love you more than my words will let me say, and I'm thrilled you married the love of your life, and that I now have a new amazing brother to annoy.
When you're walking on moonbeams and staring out to sea, 'cause if your skin was soiled, how long do you think before they start digging? And if your life was gold, how long do you think?
would first like to congratulate the bridesmaids for making the cut. It was like watching a game show, who was added, who was dropped. I imagine when Nicole got down to the last spot, she threw a pool stick on the floor in front of two girls and said, who wants the spot best? Let's have a moment of silence for the girl that didn't make the cut. Now to Ethan's selection process for the groomsmen. He's so carefree, we probably were the first five numbers in his phone book. I'm sure Ethan was a huge help picking out everything for the wedding. If Nicole hears whatever one more time, we might have to have her committed. I'd like to thank Ethan for bringing another alpha female into our family, because this family doesn't have enough of those. But in all seriousness, I'm so happy for the two of you. I'm so proud to call you my brother. You have become one of the best men I've ever met. I love you both. Congrats.
How long do you think you'll stay living? Hey!
So I wouldn't trade.